Good evening. Today we rejoice in the gifts of the Spirit that are given to us to help build up God's kingdom. We warmly welcome Archbishop Vlazny, the young people who will receive the sacrament of confirmation, along with their families, friends, and visitors who have come to share this special day on their journey of faith. Today, these young people will commit to living the Christian way of life, and they will receive the Holy Spirit to help them in the mission. Our parish rejoices as they are confirmed in the faith of their baptism, the faith of this community, the faith of the church. Please join me in praying to the Holy the prayer to the Holy Family found on the back of Breaking Bread. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, as we look at your love, we ask you to bless our homes and our families. Grant that our homes be places of compassion and prayer, authentic schools of the gospel, and small domestic churches. May we strive to be free from division in our hearts, and may we know peace, love, and forgiveness. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, may your love shine upon our families and upon our holy family. May we all grow in holiness and join with each other in prayer as we turn to you with faith, hope, and trust. May we live out our mission so that everyone feels the welcome and love that you inspire. May our faith flow to our greater community so that everyone feels the spirit of the Holy Family. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, graciously hear our prayer and be with us on our journey so that we may become like you, a Holy Family. Amen. Today we celebrate the Sacrament of Confirmation and the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand and welcome our celebrants, the Most Reverend Archbishop Vlazny and Father Rodel, assisted by Deacon Tim.
Let us sing together, Holy Spirit, number 189, 189.
Make us true. sin. So we ask you, Lord, to forgive us and help us prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you brought us the Father's love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you surround us with your Holy Spirit. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord is pleased to crush him in infirmity. If he gives his life as an offering for sin, he shall see his descendants in a long life, and the will of the Lord shall be accomplished through him. Because of his affliction, he shall see the light and fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in you. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and to find grace for timely help. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." He replied, "What do you wish me to do for you?" They answered him, "Grant that in your glory we may sit one at your right and the other at your left." Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the cup that I drink? Or be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized?" They said to him, "We can." Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right or at my left is not mine to give, but is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at James and John. Jesus summoned them and said to them, "You know that those who are recognized as rulers over the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Archbishop Vlazny, Father Rodel, Deacon Tim, I present to you these young people of Holy Family Catholic Church who have completed a period of preparation for confirmation. They have deepened their knowledge of Jesus Christ by studying the truth of our faith. They have been strengthened by God's grace in the sacraments and have been supported by the prayers and example of our parish community. Please stand as your name is called. Christian Dominguez. Natalie Dominguez. Isabella Johnson, Thomas Kane, Annie Stewart, Meriwether Stewart, Finlay Webster, and Lily Webster.
Thank you very much. So I'm delighted to accept these candidates for the sacrament of confirmation. I ask all of you now to join me in giving them a sign of our approval and our support. God bless you. What do you want? And they said, we want to be the good people. boys, we want to sit at your right and your left when you get into your kingdom, because they still had that idea that the Messiah was someone who was going to be a strong leader, become the king of the Jewish people, and defeat all the enemies who had conquered them in the past. And of course, that's not why the Father sent his Son. He sends his Son to be someone who conquered Satan, who would lead us home to everlasting life with the Father, who would bring us the gift of everlasting joy, and even give us in this life some goodness and joy that would be a foretaste of what we're going to have when we are one with our Father in heaven. So, you know, poor old James and John, they were still early in their formation. They had a lot to learn. Kind of like ourselves, I heard the story about this doctor in Oklahoma. In those rural areas, you know, a doctor's job is pretty widespread. It's not like here in Portland. And, you know, he'd get up, go visit people in their homes, take care of them. There were urgent care places like we got around here. But one day, he himself got cancer. He had three little children. And he thought, oh my, well, I'm going to leave a little recording for them. Because maybe someday they're going to want to do something special. Maybe one of them will want to be a doctor. Because one of the kids in there, they had talked about that. So in this little recording, he said, okay, you want to be a doctor? You do something like that? Are you willing to get up in the middle of the night, drive 20 miles to take care of a sick person? We probably could have waited until morning anyway to get up. If you're willing to do that, well, then maybe you will be a doctor. Maybe you can be a doctor. It's the attitude you bring. Because in order to be a medical student, first of all, you got to get through high school and college with pretty good grades. And you got to do your homework carefully. You got to prepare for classes. If you want to be a football player and be the captain of the team, well, then you got to go to practices. You got to be in good condition. You can't just get pride you want without doing some work beforehand. And it's the same way with the life of our discipleship of Jesus. And that's why today's theme, basically, and the rest of the Mass is probably Father Rodel will be talking about the call we all have to give service, service to other people. Our lives are not just about ourselves. When God gives us talents, gives us grace, gives us smarts, gives us a generous heart, it's for other people too, not just for ourselves. We who are disciples of the Lord Jesus have to make sure that he stays right there in the center of our lives, that we're willing to admit without God's help we mess things up at times, and that indeed my life is not about myself. My life is something to be shared. Parents do that all the time. Once their children are born, they're on 24/7 until you grow up. There's no way out of this. And Father Rodel, I had the privilege of ordaining him. He was in the last group of priests I ordained in the year 2012. Was that what it was? Yeah. Well, I'm not sure what it was like for him, but I know when I was thinking about being a priest, I thought, well, it might be kind of fun, you know, to celebrate Mass and preach and greet the people and play ball with the kids. But then, once I got ordained, I found out there were a few other things that went along with it that maybe weren't so much fun. That's why I never done it. We all have to be willing to go that extra mile. Now, the good news is, even though sometimes some of the challenges we face can be difficult, maybe sometimes we think beyond our ability, that's where the Holy Spirit comes in. That's the gift you're receiving tonight. If you're seeking to do what God wants you to do in your life, you can be sure he won't leave you without the tools to do the job well enough. But then you have to turn to the Holy Spirit and seek his help, okay? So that's, I think, the message for everybody this weekend in Catholic churches all over the world, that our lives aren't about ourselves. We're all called upon to be servants, just like the Lord Jesus was himself, a servant to those disciples. In fact, one of the Pope's titles is Servant of the Servants of God. Even when the Pope gets up there and says, he was prayer, he's called basically to an office of service. And we all have. So in a few moments, you'll come forward and I will anoint you with the Holy Chrism. That's our Christ child. He was blessed by Archbishop Samuel. I guess it was in Holy Week at the cathedral. And a lot of us priests came and prayed with him to bless that oil. It's the Christ child. It's the oil we use in baptism, confirmation, and holy orders. And when I anoint you with that oil, yes, it's a sign that Christ has a special love for you, a special care for you. He really does. But it's also a sign that you are called upon to be Christ for others. You can bring the love of Christ to other people the rest of your lives. And the Holy Spirit comes to help you do that, okay? And then we'll exchange the sign of peace. Now, that's kind of crazy at the moment times, isn't it? I suppose we'll just sort of follow each other. We do whatever you guys do here. There's only family church for the sign of peace. I always tell people, a nice smile is a nice sign of peace all the time. But that's not just a sign that, oh, we're good friends, let's get along. No, it's a sign that we are called, like St. Francis, who we honored earlier this month, we were called to be instruments of peace, to be peacemakers, trying to bring peace with our divisions. And so you go to bed still mad at somebody, and you haven't really made a decent effort to try and be reconciled. Make sure the first thing you do when you get up in the morning is see if you can't do that, because, you know, life is better for all of us when we get along. One of the biggest problems our world is having is that people have enemies and they never, never forgive each other. They never forgive each other. They never say, I'm sorry. I remember from Pope Francis when he was the grand pope, he said there were three things that people said more often, the world would be a better place. First of all, please. That's a sign of how you treat everybody with respect. Secondly, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It doesn't hurt to say I'm sorry. When you mess things up, the other person knows you. Yeah, I know I messed up. I am sorry. And then, thank you. Thank you. A heart filled with gratitude. And that's what we do when we come together for Mass every single time. It's the Eucharistic prayer, which is a prayer of thanksgiving to God, who gave us life, who stays near us in the presence of the Holy Spirit, who knows our stories and knows all the bad stuff in our stories, but he still keeps his fatherly gaze upon us and never lets us go. Just like your parents, maybe on your worst day, that's probably when your parents are most concerned about you. Who also is so merciful, ready to forgive you before you even ask. And the last but not least, who wants you to eat with time, joy, and goodness in this life that will hopefully be kind of a signal to you that that's what life everlasting will be. Whatever joy and goodness you experience in this life, that's nothing compared to what God has prepared for you in heaven. So enjoy this evening, accept the gift of the Spirit, and be Christ for others. God bless you. Well, now I would ask the candidates, and only the candidates, to stand, please. Not just Celia and Lucy, but all of them. So now we'll ask you, first of all, to remember your baptismal promises, the day you were made, children of God, and sisters and brothers, as you are this evening. So do you renounce Satan and all his works and empty promises?
I do.
And do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
Yes, I do.
And do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
Yes, I do.
And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost?
Yes, I do.
And do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, union of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Yes, I do.
And now I speak to all of you who are present this evening. These young people have expressed publicly their faith. It's our faith too, and the faith of the Church. So let's join them now as we proudly profess our faith in Christ Jesus our Lord by answering, Amen.
Amen.
Remember, that's the answer that always works when you don't know what else to say in church. Now I would ask the candidates to kneel and everyone else to stand. And I would ask Father Rodel to join me in extending hands over the candidates once I get to the prayer, right? Thank you. So, dearly beloved, let us pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these, his adopted sons and daughters, for already born again to eternal life through baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit of Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now you all may be seated as the candidates and the sponsors come forward for the energy.
Thank you.
Please stand. My sisters and brothers, let's now be one in prayer to God our Father, that we are one in the faith, hope, and love that the Holy Spirit brings to all of us.
For our Holy Church, in union with Francis our Pope, Alexander our Bishop, Archbishop Vlazny, and all the bishops, that God may help us grow in unity of faith and love until his Son returns in glory, let us pray to the Lord. For these sons and daughters of God, confirmed by the gift of the Spirit, that they give witness to Christ by lives built on faith and love, let us pray to the Lord. For their parents and godparents, led them in faith that by word and example they may always encourage them to follow the way of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer and lack hope, that they may be renewed by the Holy Spirit's healing touch, which will always bring peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions of Frank and Stephanie Bassett, and Jackson and Jacob Wojnar, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have passed before us in this life, may they know the everlasting reward of God's love, and may we one day reunite and rejoice together, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we praise and bless you, and we thank you so much for the gift of the Holy Spirit and the lives of the recently confirmed and all of us present. Thank you for the many, many ways in which you show your love and care for us. Inspire these 8 young women and men to be ambassadors for your good news, and bring your love and care to all who may meet in the years ahead. Bless them, all of us, particularly those for whom we have prayed in these petitions. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. As we present the gifts, let us sing together Servant Song number 378. 378.
To serve.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give him with thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. Supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
So that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect,
with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saints Sebastian, Dismas, Padre Pio, Gemma, Francis, Cecilia, and Lucy, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely on faith.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation before your glory advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm your faith and charity, your bulk and church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and the center of Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people we have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, in your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Your departed brothers and sisters and all who are pleasing to you, at their passing on this life, we grant admittance to your kingdom, and there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom we bestow in the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Number 587. Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Again, to all of you, I would like to thank you all for coming to our celebration tonight as we celebrate the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time, of course, the confirmation of our wonderful, newly confirmed now. And we are so blessed, for them to be the reason for us to be gathered, of course, Jesus Christ, and also for us to be gathered in, you know, for them to be able to receive the confirmation. So I would like to ask our newly confirmed to please stand up so we can please give them a round of applause. So, so I hope that clap, how loud they are, manifest, and can you feel our love, our support, and our prayers for you as you continue your journey of faith. And I know that when you receive confirmation, it's no longer because your mom or dad asked you to be confirmed, right? Because it's your decision. Yes? Yes. All right. So again, thank you so much for stepping up, and we believe in you, and the church is so bright because of, you know, of your faith and the witness that you're going to share to each and every one of us. So again, thank you so much again to our newly confirmed. Let's give them a round of applause. And I would like also to thank the team that prepared them throughout this time for their confirmation. If they could stand up, Mike, Kasten, Chrissy, and who else? God. And let's give them a round of applause for this wonderful day. They have given their time, their commitment, and their faith to us in order to share that to our newly confirmed, and of course, to be there for them and guide them. So again, I thank you in behalf of Holy Family and the Church for your dedication and your commitment. And of course, for your witness as well to our kids and to all of us. Again, thank you, thank you. I suppose that Holy Family is all about clubs. So I just want to let you know about that. And also, I'd like to thank our parents and sponsors here, and of course, the rest of the family who have come to support our newly confirmed. It takes a village, and your witness for them, they will not be here without you. So again, to our parents, thank you so much for your support, for your witness, for your faith as well. And our sponsors, you are now the second parents for them as well. And all of us here as well, because we are Holy Family. As I've said, it takes a village. So again, I thank you for your witness as well. So thank you, thank you. Last but not the least, I'd like to thank our main celebrant, Archbishop Vlazny, for being here to confirm our newly confirmed. And it worked. We have some complications, but we are so blessed to have Archbishop Vlazny to be here with us. And as he has mentioned, I'm one of the last class that he ordained. So myself, I thank Archbishop Vlazny for his trust to ordain me. So I don't know where we are with that one. So, if you are thankful for my priesthood, say thank you to him. But if you're not, you can blame Archbishop. Archbishop, thank you so much for your witness, and you've been always a father to us. And so we are so blessed with your presence here. Thank you.
Something in life happened to you because of your parents' choice. your life, your faith, your living uniform, belonging to holy family, parents, going to school, being educated. All those things you haven't had much of a choice about. So they're all good things. So being confirmed is kind of a completion of what the parents chose for you when you were baptized. That a relationship with God, which they have in their hearts, is something they wanted to share with you. It's kind of like your friends, you know your friends. And people who are friends with God like to have other people be friends with God. And that's our desire for you. The most important thing is that you maintain that friendship, that you stay in touch with God. And by the way, when I'm before Mass, I'm asking, how many times have you visited Holy Family Parish? And I do remember a couple of times. One time I came, it was the New Year's Eve of 1999, ready to turn the millennium, and we dedicated this beautiful church, and that was, of course, Father Bob's big party night. That was not only did we have the celebration of the church, we had a continuing celebration, which I, of course, eventually left, because I had some ass the next morning. I don't know how he did it. But then I was here a couple of times, Father Rodel, when you were way back home. I came as a sophomore. One mass I remember was a mass with the kids for the opening school year. But I think that might have been that school year 2 years ago when everything went wrong afterwards. So I didn't do very well. That was the focus here. Classes sort of stopped. And at any rate, but it's always been great to visit with good people of Holy Family. I've come to know many of the parishioners of Holy Family, apart from your involvement in the parish, but from the work in the city of Florida and in our diocese. But it's time to go home. We've been here long enough. And I'm not a man, but I have my own children. So please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
All your guides will bless you. Heavenly Father, we praise and bless you as we celebrate this gift of the Holy Spirit through the lives of the living room. Thank you for all the blessings you have conferred upon them from our lives. Fill them with the spirit of gratitude. And make them truly your ambassadors, your goodness and love in today's world. In this favor we ask, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and glorify the Lord by your life.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Let us sing together. We belong to you, number 635. 635.
Gifts and fillers.